All right, all right, all right. We are back here at Song of the Day, coming to you from the Rock Cave. I'm your host, Mark Pierce. It's Wednesday, Wanderlust Wednesday. We are back in the cave after a week or so. Wow. You know, it's been rough getting episodes out at the end of the year here. Doing our best. This one's probably going to be a Rock Cave short. Not too many of those. Maybe someone will say, more talking. I don't know. We're not sure. I'm trying to get this episode out today. I wasn't sure I was going to be able to do it. But it is Wanderlust Wednesday, and I don't even know if this counts as a Wanderlust theme, but we're going to give it a shot. This song has been being played on one of my satellite radio stations pretty regularly. I keep catching it, and I'm like, you know what? I don't really know much about this band, and I think I'm going to catch some flack for not knowing much about this band. That's few and far between as far as the stuff that I usually talk about, because when I talk about a band, I usually have a story to tell about me seeing them in concert or the song when I was younger or something. And this band I knew nothing about, so much so I knew really nothing about. The song I knew a little about, but again, I don't remember really seeking it out and listening to it. But we're talking about the band, the Sugarcubes. And this sounds like a band that Michael Murray would have covered on Forgotten Fridays. Is that true, Michael? You'll have to tell me. But anyway, the Sugarcubes band out of Iceland, I started reading about it, and I was like, oh, the only artist I can think of off the top of my head from Iceland is Björk. And so I keep reading, and Sugarcubes are Icelandic, formed in Reykjavik in 1986. They were active from 86 to 92. And Fletcher and Ollie are also interested in this. The lead singer is Björk. Okay. There you go. So that's what I learned when I started reading about the band. It makes sense from the vocal point of view, because I hear the song and I'm like, do I like it? Do I not like it? The voice, you know. But I did not know that the singer of the Sugarcubes was Björk. So have at it. Anyway, formed in 86, like I said. When they actually did first form, first of all, Björk had her first album when she was 11 years old. She's got a 3-octave range. But I read that the day they formed was the day that Björk had a baby. So I don't know. That's what I heard. But anyway, signed to an independent local label and then to a bigger label. Their debut came out in 1988, Life's Too Good. And legendary BBC DJ John Peel played the single Birthday. And that ended up being voted the number one song of the year in 87. For all of his listeners, and got picked up by New Music Now, and basically was a worldwide hit. The band is quirky, because Björk, of course, is quirky, but the band's music is quirky. They compare it to, like, the B-52s, or these guys, you know, kind of art rock, fun rock, whatever you want to say. Obviously not as big, but they got exposure. They came touring in the United States. They were on Saturday Night Live and did Birthday, and I think they did another song, was it Motorcade or something? I forget what it was. They put out another album in 89, which was decent. A little bit less vocals from Björk, a little bit of criticism there, but it was decent. And then their third and final album in 92. So that was a short career. And of course, Björk went on to do all the great things that she's done. So, Sugarcubes' Birthday, I hear it, and I'm like, oh, it's got some Concrete Blonde in there for me, or, you know, I'm trying to figure it all out. And I do like the song. So that's why we're here today, because I don't usually talk about music I don't like. And so that's the song of the day, Birthday from the Sugarcubes. But someone's got to tell me, were you listening to the Sugarcubes? Let's see, 1987, that was around the time they had 120 minutes on MTV, right? So that probably was on there. But I don't remember listening to this. I guess in 87, 88, I was either in some hair metal phase or New Jack Swing. I don't know what we were listening to. Bobby Brown, I don't know what. But anyway, this is not part of my musical memory, so I need you guys to tell me if you guys have memories of listening to this album by the Sugarcubes that was so well received. Let me know. All right, Björk, there you go. Something new we haven't covered here in the cave. Speaking of Wanderlust Wednesday, 2024, we're going to do the Criterion treatment to a bunch of my first-year episodes of Wanderlust Wednesday, because I've been thinking about that for a while, so we're going to do that. As far as next episodes are concerned, I don't know if we're going to have any till after the first, because I'm going away this weekend. So this might be the last one of 2023. We'll see. But if there's going to be an episode, It would be tomorrow or Friday. We'll see. We're working on it. Sorry. Stick with me. But we're going to have a lot more regular episodes after the new year when life settles down. So whatever you're doing today, I hope it involves music. Thanks for sticking with me. And as usual, I'll catch you on the flip side.